In the next few problems, we're going to be finding the domain and range of piecewise functions. Here's what a piecewise function looks like. And really, the only good way to find the domain and range of a piecewise function is to graph it. So what we're going to do is we're going to graph each piece of this piecewise function. We're going to put them together onto the same graph. Then we're going to look at that remaining function and find what the domain and range is. So it's especially important with these next few problems to remember what graphs of functions look like. In this case, what we're looking at is y equals 2x plus 4, which you'll recall is just a line. It has a slope of 2 and a y-intercept of 4. So a slope of 2 means up to right 1 or down to left 1. We can continue counting out those points, and eventually we connect them with a straight line. However, with a piecewise function, we're told that this line is only the function for x values that are less than or equal to negative 2. Now this function is only really that piece for all of these x values to the left. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to erase all of the pieces of the line where x is greater than negative 2. Okay, so this is all we're left with for this piece of the function right here. Let's graph the second piece. Okay, y equals x minus 3 is another line. It has a y-intercept of negative 3, and it has a slope of positive 1. And if we connect all the dots, our line is going to look something like that. Again, however, this line is only part of this function for when x is greater than 0. What does that mean? Well, all of this part of this line here, where x is less than or equal to 0, shouldn't be part of this function. This green line should only be part of this function for x is greater than 0. I'm going to erase everything else. Okay, so what's left? Well, this function turns out to just be this piece, this blue piece right here, combined with this green piece right here. Notice we left an open hole here at x equals 0 because we didn't have an equal sign on this 0 here. Okay, now we just have to look at the graph and figure out what is the domain and what is the range. The domain is all of the x values on this graph. And as it turns out, we have to represent this domain in two pieces. Why? Well, because this blue piece of this graph includes x values all the way from negative infinity, because this line will go all the way off to x equals negative infinity, all the way up to a value including negative 2. When I say including, that's a closed circle. In interval notation, that is a closed bracket, as opposed to a parenthesis, which we always put on infinity and negative infinity. The second piece of our domain is going to come from this green function here. You'll notice if you look at it, this green piece includes all x values between 0 and infinity. You can extend this green line off forever between 0 and infinity. Notice there's an open circle here at x equals 0, so we're going to use a parenthesis. Now those are the two pieces of our domain. How do we combine them? Well, in interval notation, we call that a union. Put a little u in between them, and that is our domain. Now the range looks a little bit more complicated, but it's actually pretty simple. If you look at this graph and you ask the question, what y values are included on this graph? Well, all of them are. This blue piece here includes all y values from negative infinity all the way up to 0. This green piece here includes all y values from negative 3 off to infinity. There isn't a y value on this graph that isn't included in this function. So the answer is all real numbers in an interval notation that is negative infinity positive infinity. If this seems a bit confusing to you and you're looking for another way to look at why the domain includes two intervals and the range only one, look at the x values that aren't included in this graph. There's this whole region right here where this graph does not exist for any of these x values. There's a gap, and that gap is the reason why we have to split our domain up into two intervals. Okay, hopefully that will help you out with the next couple of problems. You're going to be graphing piecewise functions, then looking at that graph, figure out what the domain and range are. It will help you to recall the basic shapes of graphs from your previous studies. Here, x squared is a parabola in green. I also, in pink, have some shifts of these basic graphs drawn. X cubed looks something like that. Don't forget the square root. Looks something like this, this orange thing right here. This pink graph here is actually the square root of negative x. That's a reflection over the y-axis. In purple here is the absolute value of x. And down here is a reflection over the x-axis of that function. That would be negative absolute value of x. Okay, hopefully those will help you along the way as well. Good luck.